So what are the key obligations under FATCA, the US Foreign Accounts Tax Compliance Act?
The key obligation under FATCA is for foreign finance institutions, that is institutions who are outside the US, to provide information to the IRS on their US account holders. The way they do that is by signing up to an agreement with the IRS under which they will be required to provide that information. Subject to a few limited exceptions, all foreign banks and indeed other financial institutions such as custodians and brokers will be required to sign up to one of these agreements with the IRS.
And in a nutshell, if they don't sign up to one of those, what would be the implications for them? What would they be required to do under FATCA?
If a financial institution didn't sign up to an agreement with the IRS, there will be 30% withholding applied on any payments to that financial institution. Now, it's important to note that that withholding isn't just on things like interest or dividends, so not just on income, but on principal as well.
And so in the context of a loan agreement, what does that mean?
In the context of a loan agreement, that means that potentially both principal and interest under the loan agreement could be subject to a 30% withholding if the agent and the syndicate have not signed up to an agreement with the IRS.
And could there be any reason why an agent or a syndicate would not want or be able to sign up to such an agreement?
At the moment, it's very difficult for agents and syndicate members and banks generally to know what the scope of this agreement will be. The form of the agreement itself hasn't actually been published yet. So one of the key issues in the market at the moment is that when looking at loans in the context of trying to allocate FATCA risk between the parties, the financial institutions don't actually know the scope of what they're going to need to sign up to with the IRS. So in particular, they don't know what detailed information they're going to have to provide to the IRS. The other side of that is also that the type of information they might have to provide could be in breach of data protection rules in the EU. So on the one hand, financial institutions are being required by the IRS to deliver information to them. On the other side, they're being told by the laws of their home jurisdiction that they can't provide that information because it breaches data protection rules. So financial institutions at the moment are caught between a rock and a hard place. And that is something that's going to have to play out over the coming months when the details of the IRS agreement that the financial institutions will be required to provide become clearer.
And do we know when detail is expected and when the FATCA implementation timetable is due to kick off in earnest?
Well, it's slightly difficult to say at the moment. The timetable was initially that the form of the IRS agreement would be published in the early part of this year. So far, it hasn't been published, and many think the reason for that is the large amount of lobbying that's happened to the IRS in terms of the actual scope of what banks need to sign up to. However, that said, the intention is that banks will have to start signing up to the IRS agreement from the beginning of next year, at which point as well grandfathering protection is lost. However, the actual FATCA withholding then starts to kick in a staged process. So at the beginning of 2014, withholding on income and interest starts to be levied. At the beginning of 2015, withholding on principal starts to be levied. And then at the beginning of 2017, withholding on so-called foreign pass-through payments. They are payments where the person making the payment isn't a US entity, but is in fact a entity that's signed up to the IRS agreement itself and is then making a payment to an entity that hasn't. They will be subject to withholding at the beginning of 2017.
Grandfathering is something which has been discussed extensively in the banking community. Is that something which provides a complete get-out card for loans being entered into today?
I don't think grandfathering is something that provides a complete get-out-of-jail card for banks. It's clear that any loan agreement entered into before the beginning of next year will be get the benefit of grandfathering. However, that grandfathering can be lost if material amendments are made to that loan agreement after the beginning of next year. A material amendment is an amendment that affects the pricing or the term or the credit of the underlying loan. So any extension to the term, any adjustment to the margin or other fees will lose grandfathering. as will a change to the security package or the guarantor package. It is also possible, although we do not know the answer to this yet, that changes to financial covenants and other covenants, if they are sizable enough in scope, could also lose grandfathering. So in practice, there are many, many changes that could be made to a loan agreement that could lose grandfathering, and suddenly that loan will be subject to FATCA withholding, even though it was entered into during the grandfathering period.
And today, what would you recommend that banks and borrowers do to protect themselves against FATCA risk in their loan documentation?
I think the key thing banks and borrowers should be looking at is the protecting against losing grandfathering. That is including provisions in the loan agreement that ensure that any amendment that could lose grandfathering is flagged and the changes that come from that can be dealt with at the time. I think the main thing that can be done in that respect is to make any change that could lose grandfathering protection an all-lender decision and also require the agreement of the agent, importantly. That would then allow any lender to have the ability to agree to that change and also ensure that any changes as a result of it do not get put through without that lender having a say. Other than that, I think it's very difficult at the moment to be too prescriptive in terms of what changes can be put into a loan agreement. That is simply because of the uncertainty as to where FATCA will actually come out of. In particular, the lack of knowledge of what the final IRS agreement that financial institutions are going to need to sign up to will be. I also think that because of the economic impact that a withholding would have, that is that either the borrower or the lenders are going to have to take a 30% hit, depending on where the risk is allocated. Loan agreements going forward are very likely to be structured to simply ensure that that withholding doesn't apply. So, for instance, there could be covenants in the agreement that the borrower needs to be a non-US entity or have non-US source income. On the flip side, if that isn't feasible, I think borrowers are likely to require that their lenders and the agent are participating financial institutions so that withholding doesn't apply. I think that otherwise it's going to be very difficult for loan markets to operate if FATCA is a withholding that applies on several loan agreements.
Thank you very much.